A lot of people just buy things because they like it. They don't really need it, or they already have a lot of things, like a lot of clothes or, a lot of shoes. In fashion, there's like something called throwaway fashion because trends are always changing, constantly every season, not even every year, but constantly. Clothing now is even made cheaply, like cheap material, like it can be easily like torn. It goes out of style, so they don't want it anymore, so they don't know what to do with it. I've heard people say that they usually throw away their clothes, and that's so weird to me. I think that's a problem with throwaway fashion because landfills are being like filled with like all this clothes because it's not in style anymore, and that really affects like everything, all our environment, a lot of people who would throw away certain things, bring it to the free market. Or people who would donate to other companies like Goodwill or like, these thrift stores that sell them back to like poor people basically. And in this way, there's generally like you're giving it to people who need it. There's no middle person and there's no buying involved. So I think it helps reduce waste and like reuse things that, sometimes like people are like, oh, this is out of style. I don't want it anymore. But someone else is like, I just want somebody to wear, So all of these free markets in different cities basically started with people like that heard about it and they're like, hey, I want to do this too, right? This seems like a good idea to reduce waste and to not consume so much, especially when there's no need. So the free market is basically a temporary market, which is a gift economy. That's really important because a lot of people think that the free market is like that you trade stuff or barter with other people, but everything's free. There's no money involved. A lot of people don't really understand that concept. Sometimes people provide not just like items, but skills or services. A couple of times we've had people do haircuts for homeless people or for anyone in different skill sharing like that. This next free market that we're doing, we're gonna do a thing where if people have like torn clothes or something's wrong with like a zipper's missing or a button, and if they wanna bring it, we can help them repair it. Or show them how to repair it also, so they can learn how to do it themselves, and not just depend on other people to do it for them. So that's one way, like, to help, keep things, especially when some people like the things that they have. So different kinds of people go to the free market. We have it at a park, at La Palma Park, where it's known for having a homeless population. Homeless folks see us all the time. And they know that we're gonna be there like once a month. So they come along, we post things up like on social media, on, Facebook, Instagram, also Craigslist and stuff like that. So a lot of people from all over, like from different cities even come because they've never heard of it sometimes. And they're like, oh my God, what is this? And so they find it interesting and come and check it out and bring stuff also. And they also say the same thing usually. They say like, oh, this is much better to give it to someone who needs it than to giving it to Goodwill, who's just gonna sell it.
The idea of this being strictly community-based felt a lot realer. Throwing it away, it's wasted. Taking it to a Salvation Army, to a Goodwill, it just seems so monetized. It just seems so much more, I'm conforming to what has to be going on, where it's a business. Here, it's take what you want, leave what you want. At the end of the day, somebody's gonna get use out of it. It's better because you can see that there's use being gone out of it. You can see that there's people that come by. You can see that there's people that do care and want to give. At a Goodwill, you're just gonna see people going in to buy stuff for themselves instead of it going to people that really need it.